Hello, my Virgo friends. How are you doing today? How have you been? Hopefully your weekend was well. Thank you so much for stopping in and checking out your horoscopes. So this week is going to bring you clarity on certain issues. But be careful, because during this period, you'll tend to allow people into your life who do not deserve it. But, inch by inch, slowly but surely, patience, if you let the patience work, it'll give you confidence and security every step of the way. The moment allows you to meet people with whom you can achieve unexpected triumph. You are far from the harmony you've been frantically struggling to get for days, but you're certainly not able to make any promises without lack of careful consideration and analysis. So don't make any promises you can't commit to, and know that you can't commit to. Reflect on your plans for the near future. You are looking forward for financial gain. It's coming. It's coming, my Virgos. Changes are useful, but only if they're not surprising and you are prepared for them. So be prepared for some surprises. Maybe the tarot will pick up on that, hopefully. Expect the unexpected, just in case. Any sort of short distant travel will be highly successful, but be cautious when making promises. That came up twice. So, yeah, don't make any promises you can't do. You know what I mean? Shall we see what your tarot has to say? Tarot. All right, spirits, please give me a clear message for my Virgo friends for the week of June 10th through the June 16th, 2019. Here we go. General reading. Excuse me. Home life. Love life. And social life, career, work, and money. Some insight. And the good, the bad, and the unknown. All right, my Virgo friends. Your overall feeling for the week is imprisonment with that Eight of Swords. It could be imprisonment or not looking at the whole picture. So, without further ado, let's go ahead and see what is going on. Well, you got to, something is completing a cycle. Some of you might be, it looks like you might be learning a new trade or learning something new in your life. And you obviously like it because you're determined. You're determined to do this. This card, when this comes up, this is one of the special cards in the deck. And it means be you. Be authentic to you. The card is you are one. And its meaning is authenticity. When this comes up, somebody wants you to change the way about you. Whether it be your morals, whether it be something about you. Don't let that happen. That's part of you. But with the ending of the general reading, you have the world. That's a completion. That's a completion of a cycle. So I kind of get feeling that you've been, whether it be studies in school or whatnot, or just something in your life, maybe even a hobby, you've ended that and gone another way of learning something, or maybe like a second part of it. But I'm kind of feeling it's like something new with that completion card. Like I said, whatever this new thing is, you're determined. You're determined. And with the Eight of Pentacles, that's practice. That's getting to know it. That's studying it, mastering it. Well, not mastering it yet, but you're determined, so you want to master it. And that whole just be you. If that's what you want, then go for it. In your home life, we have it might be a little rocky this week. I feel like they're sticking together, but they're not. In home life, love life, social life, it looks like that there is something is getting changed. Something there's confusion about something. And it has something to do with morals, your morals and how you think. It looks like you're trying, whatever this thing is, you're trying to be flexible. But hold on, what, guys? It's like something is, and maybe it has to do with this card, You Are the One, because somebody, it seems like somebody's trying to change your morals, and you're like, no, 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 and you see what's going on with the Hangman. That's perception. You see what's going on. And that could very well be where the imprisonment comes from. You feeling imprisoned and they're trying to change your morals. And I get the feeling like it came out of nowhere. And that's why the confusion came up. It came out of nowhere, like all of a sudden, and I don't mean this in a bad way, but all of a sudden somebody came up and was like, very godlike when they weren't before, and you're like, what the heck's going on? But you're trying to be flexible with them, but it seems like they're just not working with it, and you just desire to, with the Knight of Wands, you're just, maybe it's you changing. You're changing what you're, and somebody don't like it. That's what I'm getting at. Somebody, you're changing the way that you're thinking. To get balance. Yeah, there we go. Alright, some of y'all are changing the way you're thinking about different things. Yeah, especially with the Two of Swords and the Two of Pentacles. It's all about that balance, and it has something to do with your morals, whether you're, you know, going down another path or what. But whatever it is, it's going to cause disruption in the family, in your family, your home life, your relationship. That tower is there. So be expecting that. A little, you know, like a little not so nice feedback on that. But it's nice to know, you know. instead of wondering how they're going to react, it's nice to know that they're going to act a certain way, at least in my eyes. All right, fam, or home, no. Career, job, money. Let's see what's going on here. Oh, somebody's regretting something. I almost got the feel that somebody went on a new venture with the Page of Wands, or is going on a new adventure. And they're going at it with determination. And it looks... whoever's going on this new adventure when it comes to career or work, with the Page of Swords, inspect it really good. Because the reason I say that is because there's regrets. Now, I don't know if it's regrets for leaving your work, the other workplace, if you're leaving somewhere to go to somewhere else, but there's some regrets somewhere. But that's the only other thing, that's the only thing I see that it would be bad. But with the inspection card coming up, the Page of Swords, is like information. It's an information card, okay? So that's telling me that there's something about this new job that might be, you weren't expecting at least. You weren't expecting something and you kind of regret leaving your other job. And it's definitely a new venture with the Page of Wands. A lot of pages here. You're starting new. But the Magician came up, which means inner skills, inner wisdom. You're manifesting. And the Ten of Pentacles came up, which is like legacy. Abundance, wealth, success. So, I mean, this new venture isn't a bad thing. You're just going to be aware that you're going to regret a little bit about something that has to do with this job. It's not all what it looks like, if that makes sense. All right, now let's get to some advice cards. We have Three of Wands, Ace of Cups reversed, Nine of Pentacles, and Three of Pentacles. A lot of money. Wow, too money. Okay, first off, it looks like you're working to master something. You're working to master something that's taken a lot of patience, but patience are going to be rewarded with that Nine of Pentacles. The patience is going to pay off and it's going to be rewarded. So you've been waiting for something. You've been waiting for something. I am going to read, because this Ace of Cups is reversed. I've never had a reversal, only one other time in this deck. So with these decks, I'm not sure of the reversals. And I usually don't have reversals. But it came up a reversal for you. So let's see what is going on. Okay. So, when reversed, this card implies a feeling of depletion and emptiness. You're hiding, denying, and faking your true feelings for someone or something. Your feelings are not fully developed yet. You may also feel abandoned or that your emotions are still raw. So there you go. Whatever it has to do with this, just wait it out. Whatever it is this is about, it's like you're waiting for something. And it's like you're telling somebody, it's coming, but you really don't know. That's what I get from the Ace of Wands or Ace of Cups being reversed. You're like, it's coming, and you really don't know when it's coming. But, like I said, or somebody's like, I almost get two. Somebody's like, why are you doing this? Almost like, why are you, say if it is about like career, why are you going down this new path all of a sudden? And you're like, because I want to, but there's another reason there. But you're learning to master it. With the Three of Cards, you're working your butt off. You're working your butt off. Just like I said, have patience. Because with that Nine of Pentacles, the rewards are coming. And you're manifesting what you need to manifest with that Magician card. So, things will be clearer. All right, so. Okay. So it looks like with the good, the bad, and the other, it looks like you were feeling a little, as my oldest daughter would say, meh. Meh. I hate that word. But you were feeling bored, stifled, just dissatisfaction with things. And your ambition led you to do whatever it is these cards are representing, this new thing in your life. And Nine of Cups, satisfaction. It's all going to come to a head and it's all going to work out great. Things are going to get much clearer. It seems like the reading, the feel of the reading, the whole feel of the reading is like right now you're up in arms. You don't know what's going to happen. You don't know why you're doing something, but you're being led down that way. And there's nothing wrong with that. Obviously, if it's not like against the law or anything. But no, you're not sure why you're being led that way, but you just feel this like strong pull towards it. And the feelings I get is it's going to work out. It's going to work out. There's a reason you're being pulled that way. And it's definitely going to work out. You just have to be honest, be true. But, like your horoscope says, don't allow people in your life that don't deserve it. And I think a lot of with the horoscope, too, was a lot of with the inch by inch, slowly but surely, patience will give you confidence. It has to do with this new thing, this new venture that you're going on. All right. My spirit and my shadow and light oracle, what fairy is with Virgo this week? What do they need to know or hear? What do they need help with? Give me one card, please, of what they need to know. Who is with them this week? One more shuffle and then I will pull one if none pops out. Oh. Oh, one of my other readings got this too. Putting on that masquerade. Marie Masquerade. Glamour, intrigue, and drama. Okay, let me get that for you. 14. Number 14. All right. Someone is about to invite you to be involved in something very intriguing, and this person will ask you in ways that are ever so charming, so the temptation will be ever so strong. Because this person is beautiful and talented and powerful, you are flattered. But the truth is, you run the risk of paying a very high price for the brush of fame and glory. Be sure that the politics and the intrigues are ones you truly wish for in life, because there is often sacrifice that must be made, and many consequences are currently hidden from you. It is tempting, no doubt, but it may not be within your best interest to pursue this strange, slightly tainted offer that will be made. So there you go. Kind of like what the card said and what your horoscope said. Watch out for them people. And you'll know. I'm sure you'll know. You'll feel it. All right, my Virgos. There's your horoscope / tarotscope for the week of June 10th through the 16th. And I hope to see you back here next week. Remember, I also do dailies. And if you'd like a private reading, all the information is down in the description below. Thanks for joining me today, guys. Have a wonderful week and take care. Bye.